My name is Rajab Philip Muchiri, and I'm presenting a paper on the impact of broadband diffusion in assessing innovation at institutions of higher learning. Now, this is a research paper that has been extracted from my research that I'm conducting, and it is based on a paper that I read written by Bharat Chaudhary on 2012. He did a profound survey on swarm intelligence. His paper was originally based on a paper written by Gerardo Beni and Jing Wang in 1989, and it was in the context of cellular robotics. I would like to say that my paper is falls into the category of collaborative innovation networks that utilizes swarm intelligence. And we know that in computer science, swarm intelligence is applied in artificial intelligence, and artificial intelligence is an important study in computer science. Now, this swarm intelligence is actually a collective behavior of decentralized, self-organized. Before I go to my summary, before I go into the summary of my research, I'm saying that my research is inspired by nature, which is about biological systems, looks at the behavior of animals like ant colonies, bird flocking, animal herding, and bacteria growth and fish schooling. So if we can be able to use broadband to create collaborative networks between institutions of education, then we can actually say that an institution is being innovative if it is using broadband. Now, the objective of my research is that the aim of the research was to study the impact of broadband diffusion in assessing innovation at institutions of higher learning in Kenya. The background of this research was that the government of Kenya has realized the importance of broadband provision to stimulate economic development through innovation and established a Kenya Education Network Trust, which is a national research and education network that promotes the use of broadband in teaching, learning, and research in institutions of higher learning in Kenya. So the aim of this trust was to interconnect all the universities by setting up a cost-effective and sustainable private network with high-speed access to the global network. So the methodology that was used in this particular paper is that the study applied descriptive survey research design, and a logistic regression model was used as inferential analysis tool in the quantitative analysis. The inferential statistics used to analyze the model were the overall model evaluation, the goodness of fit statistics, and statistical test of individual predictors and validation of predicted probabilities. I want to remind the listeners that my research was actually based on building a model that can be used to assess whether an institution is being innovative or not innovative by the way in which it uses broadband. So the results of this analysis or the reliability measures were actually seen to be above 0.7, and this was recommended as indicator for adequate internal consistency. Inferential statistics used to analyze the model showed that the model performed well and was appropriate for this particular study. In conclusion of this summary is that broadband diffusion in institutions of higher learning in Kenya is inhibited by poor infrastructure development, which is attributed to high cost of connections and bandwidth acquisition, and at the high demand for broadband among the students and staff. Policies in broadband regulation and the use of internet from the national government and international organizations are important in controlling and enabling access to this important resource for innovative purposes. So what are the problems? What is the problem? I'm trying to say that broadband is an important ICT infrastructure that influences innovation and competitiveness. However, the assessment of its influence on innovation is not clear here in Kenya and many other countries. It is important to know that once you have broadband does not necessarily mean that you are innovative, but it depends on the way in which you are utilizing this particular broadband to create new ways of doing things and creating new products that improve production processes and therefore enhance competitiveness and development. So although Kenya continues to invest in broadband infrastructure, the extent to which broadband is being utilized in institutions of higher learning in Kenya to spur development through innovation is not clear. And that is what necessitates the development of this particular model. Institutions of higher learning often invest in technology with a clarity, but having limited understanding of how to manage the implementation process. The understanding of what leads to effective implementation and assessment once technology has been adapted remains unclear. There is also limited information understanding of the determinants and the criteria that is used or applicable in assessing effective implementation of technological innovations in our institutions of higher learning. Technology transfer initiatives by various international development sponsors and their partners in Africa are the instruments of choice, yet failure in implementation seems to be the rule rather than the exception. Technology initiative failure rate for World Bank projects in Africa since the year 2000, for instance, is estimated to be 50%. So this is a big problem in Africa. So data, the methods used. Data was collected from existing records, from literature review, and through interviews. A 5-point Likert scale was designed and employed to assess the characteristics and behavior of broadband consumer responses. Statistical methods were used to test the internal consistency, reliability, and construct validity of the study variables. The study used a logistic regression model as an inferential analysis in the quantitative aspect of the research. In the research, institutions of higher learning were viewed as adapters of broadband innovations, and once broadband innovations were adapted, consumers of broadband innovations, such as students, academic staff, and administrative staff, tend to be satisfied by the systems adapted and implemented. So if the systems adapted and implemented have been adapted successfully within an institution, then you say that is a success. And if they are not, it is a failure. That is why the model uses logistic regression, because logistic regression requires that the variables are either true or false. If something is done successfully, then you say that is true. And when it is not, then it is false. It has only two constants or two variables, a true or under false. So to test the soundness of a logistic regression model, the following tests were considered: the overall model evaluation, goodness of fit statistics, statistical test of individual predictors and validation of the predicted probabilities. The results and discussion. The constructs that were used in this study illustrated satisfactory, convergent, and discriminate validity. I want to remind my listeners that this particular study uses an algorithm that is referred to as a classification algorithm. It uses... Hello, yes, you can hear me. Yes, yes, can you hear me? Hello, yes, yes, yes. Okay, okay, I'll be fast. So the relationship between... Hello, yes, can you hear me? The relationship between variables in the correlation matrix was significant at 5% level, and the results showed that there existed a weak association between the variables. The other statistical variables are Hosmer and Lemshaw test chi-square, which gave that particular value. This shows that the model fitted very well for this particular data. Cox and Snell chi-square was also used, and it shows very well that there was fitness of the data. To test for inferential goodness of fit, the study utilized the omnibus test of model coefficients. All these are statistical methods or formulas that are used to test whether my regression model was actually fitted this particular data and was appropriate for the study. The data collected on the variable construct for this model showed little capacity to predict innovations, since the appropriate for prediction was at 59%. In conclusion and recommendation, institutions of higher learning in Kenya should ensure that adequate bandwidth is available to staff and students to comfortably perform their activities related to academic work. Connection speed is related to the number of users accessing the internet at the same time. Policy, therefore, should be put in place to ensure that the ratio of users to available bandwidth is acceptable. Access to broadband is not limited to laboratory. Yes, yes. That's my conclusion.
Your time is up.
That's my conclusion.
Yeah.
Yes, that's my conclusion. Thank you very much. Thank you.